But if you pressurize, if you want to exit the airplane in flight, which is always a possibility in an experimental airplane, it's very difficult to achieve it. To have an exit door that you can open quickly and that allows you to go out in a parachute and with all your equipment you need, the life raft and so on. So this was too much a requirement, too big a requirement. If we had been normal airplane, I think we would have had the weight budget for pressurized cabin, but with a very, very small entry doors or doors to get out again.
So what altitudes are we talking about here? What tell us about a mission typical mission profile, let's say, for the United States flight, and then for the world flight. Take off at some time, climb to which altitudes?
Every day we climb to close to 30,000 feet.
And you're doing that just on oxygen.
Which is with oxygen, exactly. It's also the altitude at which you can cope with oxygen quite well if you're not pressurized. If you're above this altitude, at a certain stage you need pressurized oxygen, which starts being more difficult. And of course, if you have a small difficulty with the oxygen system, the time that you have available to use a safety system or another system, the backup solutions, is more and more smaller. I think at 30,000 feet, you talk about something like half a minute, which is already short, to understand that you have a difficulty and that you can switch to something else. So that's some kind of a safety limit that we have defined for ourselves. And every night we will go down to a low level. This depends on meteorology, depends on the time of the year, how much are the batteries full. The goal is to be around 10,000 feet at that time. It can be lower, depending on the situation.